And what an honour it is for me this evening to welcome tUachtarán Héireann Michael D Higgins, President of Ireland, who has so graciously agreed to open our Pan Celtic International Festival. Our admiration and respect for President Higgins is boundless, not just as our country's first citizen, but also for he has accomplished all that he has accomplished and he continues to accomplish in his brand new role as President of Ireland. It is true that Ireland has not produced a more passionate political voice, serving as he has in every level of public life, including as Ireland's First Minister for Arts, Culture and the Gaeltacht, or as we affectionately know, Aran Gaeltachta. Is Fashing na Bona agus na Talan atá ag ar na tUachtarán. He is a poet and writer, an academic and statesman, a human rights advocate, a promoter of inclusive citizenship, and a true champion of creativity within our society. Throughout his life, tUachtarán has campaigned passionately for human rights and for the promotion of peace and democracy in many parts of the world. Agus mar a aithantas ar a héir ar sona síochána agus ar sona cirte, brúnach dú síochán Sean McBride ar siar sa bliain 1992. A gwini uisle, on the occasion of this, his very first visit as tUachtarán Héireann to Carlow, I invite you to stand to give a tremendous Carlow welcome, an enthusiastic Céad Míle Fáilte to tUachtarán Héireann Michael D Higgins.
Christa Carlock, Christa Archer, Agus a Court of Gale, Iana Eric Stula, Agus a Pohori, son of Tartak, Kerin, as Tierly Elias Pisi, Pisi Pisi Ash, their father, Tofir Kinohisar, Vensha, Agus Erin Gainwell, she has this Minlam of Witches, Sagoal, Le Winter Carlock, Asak, and 1440, Darish of Rome. It's quivin long new to me, Erin Bomer, some canvas or heart, some fiachtas that are booter on it, Cosmifius Galoshte, Gahala, Kurgis Fisher, Ercandes, Nahokoichi, is Tan of Vitum Hain, Augusta Sabine Vilum, Augustan Bus, New Vimar, and Thrasta. Erin Gator, she has Kamalish and Gofirmoja, Tarime, Dan, Ven, in Ur. Good afternoon, and at Confilia International to Pan Celtic, Gavila Sadoyak, Oscar to Gahifagul, August Trislium and her father, August Sisse, Kamalishin of Kohorehe, and Krista Ochure, Arena Eak, the current figure, as in Shot in the Kaye, Ganari Libra Quillera, is Gahra the Mayor Shulage. A chairperson distinguished guests, and particularly those who have travelled long distances. It's a very great pleasure to be here as tUachtarán Héireann, as President of Ireland, to officially open your 41st Pan Celtic Festival. I'd like to thank the organising committee, and in particular the Cathaoirleach Bríd Róiste, for the kind invitation that was sent to me, and which I was so pleased to accept. I should say that I have been at a number of Pan Celtic festivals. I think the festival was just ending when I arrived on my campaign in Dangan, Dangany Cush, Dingle. It's come a Kate Hedgehog at where the people of Dangan, they were wonderful. And I got a great, great reception. I have also attended the festival in Lorient a number of occasions. I remember meeting Johnny Vledrion and Alan Stivell, particularly, who remains a good friend of mine. So it's a great pleasure to be here again. You mentioned I think my previous life as Minister for Arts, Culture and the Gaeta between 1993-97, and very particularly when I was President of the Council of Culture Ministers of the European Union in 1996, it was my very definite view then that diversity is richness, and that it was very important for us to see the cultures of Europe, and particularly ancient cultures, such as that is carried, which are the common strands we hold in the Celtic communities, to see it as a rich tapestry which is continually being reworked. I said in my inaugural speech as the ninth person to hold the presidency of Ireland that I would encourage creative communities who are bringing about positive change. We had a very serious debate in Europe, one which I think continues, as to about the importance of culture. My own view is that it is not residual, it is central. It is something that is part of the spirit of people, and it is something that is shared and handed on from one generation to another. I think that one of the things that characterizes the nations that are the Celtic nations is that they have, when one looks back at the long history, been people who were never confined to space. So theirs is a kind of nationhood of the spirit. They took to their boats, they travelled, they connected with each other. And also as well, we were the Vietovodak, Ogsby Puint Lohusson, Okahore Sheshin, and Saliot, Isan Queen Arauder, Nam, Mehi, Abgnehi Orden Kalto, Kumus, Ahavo. They were forever bringing their music and changing it, never losing it. And also, I think, at the heart of their song and dance and the different other forms of even of costume and presentation of the self. It was never something that was dead to be, as it were, recalled, but something that I think, and this is the great advantage of the Pan Celtic festivals, but it is something that is being continually remodeled and reworked, and therefore it is something that is living, that draws people together, and which is celebrated. I think as well that the promote the purpose of the Pan Celtic Festival, Agus Queen Gabra or Prevetvatuk Adonor Junta, I so wish the Executive Office internationally success in promoting languages, culture, music, song and sport. And this is something I think that you yourself have said, and different committees when they organise the festival in different parts of the Celtic world, they say that not only is this something that is both modern and continually being reworked, but it is being done so as to provide, take part of a modern and contemporary world of industry and commerce. I'm sure that the people of Carlow will be well able to respond to the challenge of organising this festival, and I know you will enjoy it. I have a strange relationship to Carlow myself, and since I was a long time ago, when I was 19, the first job I was offered was as a clerical officer in the sugar factory in Carlow by General Michael Joe Costello. And he tried to persuade me to to study cost accountancy at the time. But I settled for the ESB in Galway and then after that to my different universities in different places. I think I'm particularly pleased as well is that shortly after the first Pan Celtic Festival was held in 1971, the international organisation was constituted in 1973. And I want to wish your six national committees, through you, Chairperson, every success in Scotland, Wales, Cornwall, Brittany, the Isle of Man and Ireland. I think that it is very important that they are all here. I think as well that one of the great advantages of the general festival, the 41st, which you're having now, is that it has encouraged in its long journey local festivals for, if you like, more nationally based festivals that are held in Brittany and Cornwall, in Wales and the Isle of Man. I think as well the people of where I remember of the festivals that I attended, and I know it won't be any different in Carlow, there's a great sense of celebration in the public space. And I think that the response in the shops, when I saw if we may feel good there, and Greedia, Visna, Shoppings, and the Fuinyogi, Vishikahirta, I think that that is very important. I think that as well, you know, one of the things that is fascinating and is very, very a part of the essence of the Celtic world, I think, is, I'm glad to say, there's a huge increase in the art of storytelling in Ireland. It has come back, and it is fascinating because this is an art form in itself that precedes and brings us right through the famine experience, the Garda Mór, and the immigrant experience. And it is very interesting that some of those migrants who went after the 1845 to 1848, and I'll be in the United States next week, and they brought with them fragments written in their own language, which they exchanged and which were copied, and which are part of the inheritance. They are now lodged in their original form, some of them in UCD, and they're in the Athenaeum in Boston. Because Celtic peoples have, in fact, this long memory of what it is that they share. So I think that the daily street performances, the classes, I think it's great that the classes will be there in all of the six Celtic languages, and the walking tours, and the introduction to the rich heritage that is here in the Carlow area will be very important. Just a word, you did mention, you know, about when I was minister in that period. One of the reasons that I there were two things that I think were very important. One was, I think we spent something like 147 million on putting art centres on the edges of cities and all over the country. People sometimes say, because these will be like white elephants, no one will come to them. But I'm so pleased that they are there now, and that people can go and perform, and that local populations have access to travelling companies and whatever. And the second was, of course, on top of the Wintley Television and going there. When I made the decision against the tide very much in Europe at the time, private public service broadcasting was under attack in many countries. We had the privatisation of culture and its commodification in many ways, and our government agreed to my proposal to establish an Irish language television station. That television station is mirrored now. I remember we had two young people from the Maoris community who came and studied with us for 6 months, and their station, which is now there, is modelled on television. The kind of standard that has been achieved by television, a young station with young people, Lanha, located in the Gaeltacht, is an extraordinary success. But it was based on the right of people to hear, to see, and hear, to use the new technology, the new technology, and to be able to use your own in your own language. I think myself, Kamalishin is often Lorna, Dyrfiog is often Nadola, Lugvery Ungrake Fame. Agus Lutu Garama Hain Mar Ara Gate of the V May. Agaton Gate of Tavachtak, Agus Tosh Clunch the Sauce of the Main, and Queen Wilshe Glehanu, and you want a Glehanu or Food Nature in Trina Gaiska, or Tri Draman in Aya. Karim Shekamorle or Kadi Marsha, and Seam Karman on Shot and Shot. Turisha Sprague Award, the son of Genevieve of the Greater Carconkian. Kamala Shin, Captain Hain, Ohave, and Nairot Fainte Tosha Tovachtok. There is more than just, there is the natural heritage and the built heritage, but there is the heritage of language. Sometimes I think myself as somebody who came back to the Irish language on more than one occasion, I wish that I was able to access more easily the long, long history that there is on in Old and Middle Irish of stories and songs. But I think what is wonderful is that those who have a little Irish now, they are all using it, and they're using it confidently. And it's very interesting is that I know that when there are people are now considering the naming of a Gaeltacht in Dublin itself, in Clondalkin, which is brought about by people who are interested in Gaelicus and in the Irish way of life. And they're not doing so in any version of Coelagnicus or narrow-minded. They're carrying no baggage of restriction or restraint. They're living, wonderful music making, dancing, people who are interested in the Dáil Mór, in the wider world. And they will be very, very, these kind of festivals are immensely, immensely helpful to something like that. I think that as well as this, that the links that are there, that are between all of your different groups during the week, I know that you will want to help each other. I think that the fact that six separate, distinct Celtic languages, the family of Celtic languages, are recognised, Welsh, Irish, Welsh, Breton, Scottish, Gaelic, Manx and Cornish is a matter of wonderful success for you all. I think Kamala's Chin, and it is very interesting, I sometimes take out the UNESCO book and I look at it because I still have some of these publications. And I look at all the thousands of languages that are there in our shared vulnerable planet. And every time, and it happens, that a language dies, something is lost to the world. Something is very spiritual is lost to the world. In the same way as, if you like, misguided development in relation to the environment and industrialization has not recognized our earth as a living piece, as everything as a living home for all of the different species of the life that makes up our planet. In the same way, when violence is done to the environment, we all lose. And I think we lose too when languages and languages are lost. I think we very much, it's very interesting to think of what has been achieved here. One of my predecessors, Douglas the Heather, the first president of Ireland in Cead Uthrop, when he was one of those who founded the Gaelic League at the end of the 19th century. In 1892, just 3.5% of the people under the age of 10 spoke Irish as their first language. Our language had been almost lost, and it was one of the great achievements of those who set about setting up, if you like, the revival societies in London and in Dublin and elsewhere. They brought the language to the point at which we will be able to say that one of our finest television stations is one that broadcasts through the medium of Irish, that it is spoken in the Skerrinagh Loch Gaeltacht, that people are doing so now attractively, and that many, many people who had a bad experience about learning Irish in authoritarian conditions, perhaps on occasion, are giving what I was called Antarna Chance and Shanga, the second chance to the language. All of that is rich. And I think that we should always honour, and as I do in respect, Douglas the Heather, who in 1915 took on an interesting debate that you'll be familiar with. There was a debate, the Commission on Second Level Education in Ireland in 1915. And in the Commission's hearings, Professor Mahaffey and Professor Atkinson from Trinity College both gave evidence to say, I quote, there is nothing in the Irish language worthy of teaching. And Douglas the Heather assembled evidence from Sweden, Germany, all of the major scholarly people who were interested in language itself, and presented it as evidence. It was an unemotional, demonstrable piece of evidence, and it won the day, and Irish made its way onto the cloth. I say this because I very much honour those who have had the courage, often to swim against the tide, to be able now to create the circumstances in which festivals like this can take place. And we have many projects to look forward to. There will be shortly a new English-Irish dictionary, which will come out in electronic form. And there will also be available to that, maybe there are a whole series now on the Adelaide various sites which give words in Irish, some of which I find quite strange myself, to tell you the truth. But that is the way it is. We encounter strangeness to make change. I think that I just want finally to say this festival isn't organised without an enormous amount of preparation. So may I pay tribute very much to the local committee and all of those who assist them in different ways, because when you are a committee you have to reach out beyond your own organisational boundaries, and people in Carlow, there's great gratitude to you all for the way in which you support a festival like that. I think that the name for Carlow, Cahalach Four Lakes, I think today there isn't much sign of these, but what there certainly is, there is the beautiful River Barrow that flows through this town, one of the famous, one of the great trilogy of rivers, the Barrow, the Nore, and the Shure, known as the Three Sisters. So I hope that you will be able to take advantage of this beautiful setting in which you find yourselves, and that you also go on and look at Carlow Castle and the Brownshill Dolmen and all of the other great symbols of heritage which are around here. It's been a pleasure to be here with you. Particularly, I want to once again say to those who have travelled, Fear King Fulcher over, you are really a very sincere welcome to you. Enjoy every minute of it, because it is one of the things that is one, I think, of the characteristics marks of Celtic society from old, middle and modern times, and that is that it is Celluric. It is celebratory. It isn't something that is celebratory, anything that is gone, but something that's alive and living. Something is happening in dance and music and theatre and sport and games. So, Dov Orson, Tolchefort, Orson, a ogre to go in on Dr. Sehirnu Fellow, the Pan Celtic Ostrich and Hufigur. Thank you very much for listening.